members. My name is Honorable Yusuf Gaddi. I represent Panchinkanke Kanam Federal Constituency, Mr. Speaker. I'm from Plateau State. Mr. Speaker, I rise to raise a matter of urgent public importance regarding to the incessant and barbaric killings in Plateau State that claimed the life of so many citizens of Nigerians in some weeks during our recess. Mr. Speaker, I rise pursuant to Order 8, Rule 4, and any other relevant rule to be suspended to enable me move this matter of urgent public importance, Mr. Speaker. I so move.
Honorable Gaggi, go ahead.
Mr. Speaker, this motion is on the urgent need to address the incessant and barbaric killings in Plateau State. The House notes that within the duration of our recess, a lot of ugly events bordering on the state of security of our people occurred, which I deem pertinent to call on the attention of this hallowed chamber to take necessary proactive measures toward curbing the hydra-headed monster. Further note, Mr. Speaker, that it is no longer news that the series of attacks and reprisal attacks engulfed some part of Plateau State in the recent past, ranging from the unprovoked attacks on Basa communities where scores of lives were killed, with farmlands and properties worth hundreds of millions destroyed, to the killing of peaceful commuters on Rukuba Road in Jos, North local government, on their way to Ondo State from Bauchi, and the pockets of silent killings of University of Jos students along the university community, and most recently, the killings in Yalwan Zarga community of Jos North local government areas of Plateau State. Aware, Mr. Speaker, that those barbaric killings have caused a serious breach of peace in some parts of Jos North and some parts of Basa local government. But we are grateful to God and to the effort of the governor of Plateau State, Right Honorable Simon Bakola, along to contain the ugly trend and avoid its escalation to other parts of Plateau State. Also aware, Mr. Speaker, that the said community has no voice in this hallowed chamber to air their grievances following the death of our representative, late Honorable Maitala Haruna, who died on the 2nd of April 2021, which was announced at the plenary of 13 April 2022, but till today, election is not conducted. Also aware, Mr. Speaker, that I wrote an open letter to the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria on the happening in Plateau State with proactive suggestions on how best to handle the crisis situation in the state and beyond. Acknowledge, Mr. Speaker, and appreciate the visit of Interreligious Council to Plateau State, ably headed by the Khan Chairman and the Sultan of Sokoto, and that of the Chief of Defense Staff, where they interacted and interfaced with stakeholders in Plateau on how to find a lasting peace. Resolve two, Mr. Speaker. One, observe a minute silent in honor of over 100 people killed in Plateau State. Two, Speaker, let the higher power delegation to pay a condolence visit to the government and people of Plateau and commiserate with them over the lives and property lost. Three, mandate the Federal Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs, Disaster Management and Social Development, National Emergency Management Agency, and other relevant humanitarian agencies as a matter of urgency, Mr. Speaker, to provide relief materials to the victims of attacks in Plateau in order to assuage the suffering of their survivors. Four, Mr. Speaker, commend the governor of Plateau State for taking active steps that prevented the escalation of the reprisal attacks that was imminent following the killings and the input of the security operatives in that regard. Five, urge the federal government to redeem their earlier pledge of 10 billion naira in 2020 for the resettlement of victims of attacks in Plateau, and to also extend similar privileges accorded to victims of crisis in other parts of the country to the victims of crisis in Jos Plateau State. And five, Mr. Speaker, mandate the Independent National Electoral Commission as a matter of urgency to conduct by-election to fill the vacant position of Jos North Bassa Federal Constituency without further delay, so that they can also have their voice back in this Honorable House. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, for giving me the opportunity, and I so move.
Motion.
Mr. Speaker, my motion is straight, matter of urgent public importance is straight to the point. And I won't bedevil myself going back to the content of what I have already read in this hallowed chamber. But, Mr. Speaker, it is important for us to know that the member that was just sworn in, we lost Haruna Maitala of Jos North Bassa Federal Constituency before the member from Lere died. So it beat my imagination that we have lost a colleague from Jos North Bassa where they have insecurity problem and where they should have representation on this floor of the House to speak for them. But election was conducted where a member was lost prior to the one lost in Jos North Bassa Federal Constituency. Mr. Speaker, the people are confused, and Plateau people will not want to be underrepresented on this floor of the House. It is very important to call the attention of Mr. Speaker so that the attention of Independent National Electoral Commission will be called to ensure that the people of Jos North Bassa have representation here. Lastly, Mr. Speaker, I commended the governor for obvious reasons. Mr. Speaker, you know Plateau and you know crisis in Plateau. It took the effort of stakeholders and the governor of Plateau State to ensure that the crisis was de-escalated from affecting other communities. And I urge you, Mr. Speaker, to please take the issue of having representation.
Honorable Patasi.
To please, Mr. Speaker.
You'll see you. Honorable Sai will see you.
Mr. Speaker, I urge you to take the issue of election in Jos North Bassa very serious, so that the people that are facing tremendous problem will have a representation in this hallowed chamber. Thank you for giving Plateau the opportunity, and thank you for listening to us. And we hope equally, Mr. Speaker, that all the prayers should be sustained so that you visit the Plateau people and so that intervention by humanitarian agency would equally go to the doorstep of the affected communities.
Those in support, please say aye. Those against, please say nay. Ayes have it.